Let's start with the most common interview question, which is the internal working of HashMap. To understand the internal working of HashMap, we should know what happens when JVM executes this line of code here. Here on this line, we are creating a new HashMap. So when we ask JVM to create a new HashMap, then what JVM does is in the heap memory. So why heap memory? Because all the Java objects are created inside the heap memory and HashMap is an object, right? So in heap memory, JVM will create 16 buckets. So you can see here in the diagram. Okay, so these are not literally the buckets, but the analogy with water bucket is same. In our water buckets, we store water. So similarly, this is a data bucket where we store data. Now let's represent the bucket in computer programming notion. Okay, now you know JVM has created 16 buckets in heap memory for storing items into them, and how JVM stores element in these buckets we'll see in some time. Now some of you might have question in your mind that okay, we have 16 buckets for holding HashMap items, but what if we want to put more than 16 items in HashMap? The answer is obviously yes. Yes, we can store more than 16 items in HashMap. So how does it happen? So there comes a concept of load factor. Okay, and what it says is if HashMap reaches more than 75% of its capacity, then it will double the capacity. Okay, so if 12 buckets are already full, you can see here 12 is 75%. And if 12 buckets are already full and we are trying to put item in 13th bucket, then capacity will be doubled. So the capacity initially is 16, it will be doubled to 32. So now you know what is load factor of a HashMap, right? And the load factor of a HashMap is 75%, or also called as 0.75, or also called as 3/4 of a HashMap. Okay. Now before diving into the internals, let's see what exactly is a bucket. Okay, and how the data is stored into the bucket. So here bucket is nothing but a linked list. Okay, you might already know about the linked list and how the elements are added in the linked list, but let's quickly revise this once because we will need this ahead. Linked list stores the data in the form of node. So this is one node which is pointing to the other node and which is again pointing to the next node. And this node consists of mainly two things. Obviously, one is the data that we want to store and one is a pointer. Okay, so here the pointer of the first node is pointing to the second node and the pointer of second node is pointing to the third node. And this way the linked list is created. So let's see how the nodes are added to the linked list. Initially we have zero nodes, that is nothing in the linked list. Then we add a first node with item 1. So item 1 can be anything like an object or a primitive type. Okay, now we have only one node in our linked list and the pointer of this linked list is null because it is not pointing to anywhere. Now suppose we added another node to the linked list, then the pointer of first node will point to the next node. Okay, now suppose we want to add another node into the linked list, then the pointer of second one will point to the newly added third node. So in this way the nodes are added to the linked list one by one. Now I guess you know what bucket is, and bucket is nothing but linked list having 0 or 1 or more than 1 nodes. Okay, now we know how exactly the buckets of HashMap look like. Okay, so these are the buckets, and buckets are nothing but linked list. I am showing here 3 nodes in each bucket, right? But it can be 1, it can be 0, or it can be any number of nodes in that bucket. Okay, so now you have an idea how the memory structure looks like. As we already know, HashMap is used to store key value pair. Let's try to put a key value pair in a HashMap. Here B is a key and A is a value. So when we try to put a key value pair, what JVM will do is it will get the key from the key value pair. Okay, and the key must be an object. It cannot be a primitive type. Okay, it must be an object. So right now it is a string object. Then JVM will get the hash code of a key. Here in this case the hash code is 2236. If you don't know the hashCode method, right, where this hashCode method is coming from, so it is the method which is coming from an object class, and in Java object class is the parent of all the other classes. So now you know that JVM needs the hash code of a key, and you know that hash code method comes from an object class, right? So that is the reason we cannot use a primitive, okay, as a key. We only have to use object because we want to get the hash code. Then from the hash code, JVM will calculate the bucket index using this formula here, okay, hash code. This is a bitwise AND operator, and then length minus 1. Length is the capacity of a hash map. And if you calculate, it will give us bucket index 12. That means that this key value pair will go into 12th index bucket as a node of a linked list. Okay, let's visualize it. So here you can see this key value pair will go into the bucket with 12th index, okay, as a first node of a linked list. Now you got it. So let's go for second example. Now suppose we want to put new key value pair in a hash map. This is a key value pair. JVM will take the key and it will get the hash code. So in this case, hash code is a 2424, and then calculate the bucket index. After calculation, bucket index will be 8. Okay. So now we know that this key value pair will go into 8th bucket. So let's visualize. So these are our buckets, and it will go into 8th bucket as a first node. Okay, let's go for one more example. Now suppose we want to put third key value pair in a hash map, and in this example we will see the concept of hash collision. Okay, first JVM will take the key, then find the hash code. So hash code is 2236, but can you observe here, the hash code is 2236 and the hash code of FB also was 2236, right? So let's see what will be the index. So obviously index will be calculated as 12. Now we know that this key value pair will go into the bucket index 12. But if you remember, we already have one key value pair that is already present in bucket index 12. Okay, this is how it will look like, right? That bucket index 12 is already having a node, and this is called as a hash collision. When JVM wants to put a key value pair in a bucket and that bucket is already having one node or more than one node, then this condition is called as a hash collision. In that case, what happens is JVM will check whether same key is already present or not. So if the same key is present, then JVM will replace the existing node with a new key value pair. If the key of existing node, right, that FB is not equal to the new key value pair that we are trying to insert, in that case, this new key value pair will be added as a second node of linked list. Now you know that this linked list is growing, okay. So this condition is called as hash collision. Okay, and you know what happens in case of hash collision, that it will check for the equality of keys. Okay, remember, it is for keys only. Okay, and that is the main reason why hash maps cannot have duplicate keys, right? You got it, because if we try to insert a key again, it will replace the existing key. This is one of the important concepts. Okay, those were the lengthy examples. Let's summarize the put process. When we want to put a key value pair in the hash map, then JVM will first find the hash code of a key. Then JVM will calculate the bucket index from the hash code. Now JVM know the bucket index, so there is a possibility that bucket is not empty, right? So there can be a hash collision. If bucket is not empty, or if it is empty, that is there is no node in the linked list, then it will simply add linked list as a first node. But if the bucket is already having one or more than one nodes, then in that case it is a hash collision. Okay, so what happens in case of hash collision? It JVM will check whether the key that we are trying to put now already exists in the bucket. So if the key does not exist, okay, JVM will add this new key value pair as a next node. Okay, and if the key is already present, then JVM will simply replace this existing node. Okay, so this is what put method look like. Okay, so you can take a screenshot of this. This is the important concept. Okay, so we'll see the get method of a hashmap and we'll see the Java 8 enhancements. Before we see how to get a key value pair from a hashmap, let's see how the searching works in a linked list. Suppose we want to search a node with item 3. So while searching through the linked list, we cannot directly jump to this third node. Okay, we have to traverse the list one by one from the beginning, and that is the only drawback of a linked list, because it reduces the performance as we have to go one by one traversing the nodes. While searching for node with item 3, we will first go to the first node because we have address of the first node only. Okay, so we'll go to the first node and then we will check whether the item 3 is present in first node or not. If no, then we will go to the second node and we'll check again if the item 3 is present in second node or not. If no, then we'll go to the third node and we'll again check whether the item 3 is present or not. Now we know that item 3 is present, then we will return it, and this is how the searching in linked list works. Okay, and you can see that we have to traverse one by one through the nodes, so that is a performance headache. Okay, now you know how to search in the linked list. Let's see how to get key value pair from a hash map. Here get method of a hash map is used to get the value from the hash map that we already added. Okay, so EA is already present right here. And remember, this is the specialty of a hash map. The get method of a hash map returns the value very fast. Okay, and that is why we use this hash map, because the time complexity of this get method is big O of 1. In general, it is big O of 1, meaning it will get the result very quickly. Okay, now suppose we want to find the key value pair with the key as EA. Okay, then first JVM will find the hash code of EA. Okay, hash code of EA is 2236. Then from the hash code, it will find the bucket index. So bucket index is 12. Now JVM has calculated the bucket index. JVM will go to the first node and will check if FB matches EA here. No, right? So then it will go to the second node and will check if the key here matches the key that we are sending now, right? So EA matches EA, right? Then it will return the key value pair and it will finally return the value C from the key value pair. In general, HashMap doesn't have multiple nodes in the single bucket. Ideally, it should have only one node at one bucket. Okay, but there can be hash collision and the bucket can have multiple nodes. So when there are multiple nodes, the performance will degrade, right? Because JVM will have to traverse one by one. So now here there are only two nodes. There can be a possibility that we have multiple nodes in a bucket, and in that case the performance can be degraded. And that is why in Java 8, Java people have enhanced this hash map. So now you know that if the bucket is having more number of nodes, then finding item in that bucket takes the time. So that means the get method will take the time. Now consider this scenario that we are trying to add some key value pairs. Okay, but the catch here is every key here is having the same hash code, right? So if they are having same hash code, they will go into the same bucket, right? Like this. So now you know it has a lot of nodes in a single bucket. So that is a performance degradation. So when this happens, Java 8, Java people had made an enhancement to improve the performance in this case. Okay, so they came up with an idea of converting this linked list into the tree structure when that number of nodes reaches certain threshold. Okay, and that threshold is called as a treeify threshold. Okay, so if the number of nodes reaches that certain treeify threshold, this linked list will be converted to tree. So let's see how the tree structure works. Okay, so here let's see how the elements are stored in a tree. Okay, suppose we want to store integer values. To make it simpler that how the tree works, let's store integer values. Okay, consider the first node is with integer. First we want to store 4. Okay, so this way we got an node. Then a node with value 6, so it will go above because 6 is greater than 4. Okay, then comes 2 will go down because 2 is smaller than 4. Then comes 7, it is greater than 4 as well as 6, so it will go up. Then comes 3 is smaller than 4, then it will go down but greater than 2, so it will go here. Then comes 5 and will be added to the tree, and then comes 1 and it will be added to the tree, like that. So now you got an idea how the tree structure is created. Now what is the benefit of this tree over the linked list? Now suppose you want to search for a node with an integer value 1. Okay, then JVM will first go to 4, and then it knows that 1 is smaller than 4, right? So it will go down to the node with value 2, and it knows that 1 is smaller than this, so it will go down, right, and will find 1. So instead of traversing all the nodes, it has to traverse only few nodes, right? So this is the benefit of using tree. Okay, and this way the performance is improved. There are few more things that you should know. The first one is, now we know that the integers 4 is greater than 2, right? But in case of other object values, right, or a string or any other objects, how JVM will determine that a particular object is greater or smaller, right? So in that case, JVM uses the compare to method. So when some object comes here, then JVM will use compare to method, okay, to compare whether it will go up or it will go down. Okay, so this is the thing that you should remember. And this tree is also called as a red black tree. This is black red black tree. Okay, it is a red black tree, and it is a binary search tree, and it is also a self balancing tree. Self balancing is a very simple concept. You can search it over internet or tutorials point. Okay, you will get it. So you have to remember these things, that when it reaches a tree file threshold, the linked list will be converted to the tree. Okay, and to convert it into tree, right, for the comparison that whether it will go up or down, JVM uses compare to method, and it is a red black tree, it is a binary search tree, and a self balancing tree. And I think that's it. Now you are ready for all the questions related to the hash map. So in the next video, some more practical interview questions on hash map, and also we will go deeper into equals and hashcode method contract, and we will also see overriding equals and hashcode methods. So thank you. See you in the next video.